is my latest analogy. Okay, why people need to go to AA meetings or NA meetings or Gamblers Anonymous meetings, GA meetings, I think they call them. There's CMA meetings, Crystal Meth Anonymous meetings. There's Al-Anon, there's Nar-Anon. Why do these groups work? And why are we so resistant? This addiction, this alcoholism that I have, as I've talked about in every video that I've done, is a mental illness. This is a mental problem, right? There's two things going on here. There's the physical addiction, the mental obsession, right? That I'll be able to drink somehow someday like a normal person. This constant thought, right? Trying to get me back to drinking. And once I drink, the allergy kicks in and I cannot stop. Or drug or whatever I'm doing to treat my alcoholism. Okay, so if you understand that concept that there's something wrong with your thinking. I shared that this morning in a meeting that, you know, every time I have drank again, when I've relapsed, I was sober when I did that. I'd like to think that all of my worst decisions were when I was drunk, but when I relapsed, I was sober. So, not okay up here, right? And then my mind wants to rationalize and justify everything in my life. Right? I go into kind of a state of denial where it all makes sense to me. So my analogy is like a pilot. When a pilot gets in a plane and he gets in fog or, you know, weather conditions, it's mandatory that they go to instrument flying. They instrument fly, right? They don't fly by their, like what they feel. Right? The weather's bad. They can't see. You know, it's a known fact that people have been found to be flying like upside down and think that they're right side up. Right? There's no gauge there. They've lost their bearing and they have to go to instrument flying to help keep them this way. Right? And not flying into a mountain. We've seen that a lot where people really, the pilot thought that they were flying right. That's what alcoholism is. See, when I get into shitty thinking, I don't know I'm in shitty thinking. I think I'm okay. I think I'm flying even, upright, everything's okay, right? And I'm not. All of a sudden, I'm okay. I'm flying this way, but you guys are all wrong, right? Everything's wrong. You're wrong. I don't want to listen to you. That's what happens with alcoholics, is we start thinking that our thinking is right and everybody else is wrong. And that's just like the pilot who's flying through fog on his own senses, right? And he's heading towards a mountain or he's going straight down. You've heard that too, right? They just plummet straight into the ground. And so going to a 12-step program helps you. It's like the instruments on a plane. It helps you keep your bearings, right? And sometimes you don't get your bearings because someone's telling you, you know what, Karen, you're messed up. You're not, you know, snap out of it. No, no, no. Sometimes it's because I can see that you are not going right. You sound cuckoo. Oh my God, that's not right. This is right. See what I mean? Now, I'm not saying you're going to crash into the ground. But I'm saying that listening to different people talk and hearing the directions that they're going sometimes helps me get my, oh my gosh, this is where I'm supposed to be. Does that make sense? So the 12-step program works really well, not because you're going to go and people are going to tell you what to do. It's going to work really well because you're going to see the reality of your condition. You're going to be able to see things that you normally couldn't see alone in your house, on your couch, justifying and rationalizing everything that you do. Okay? So that is the power of a 12-step program. Now, this is good not just for the alcoholic. This is the same for codependents and enablers, you know, because your thinking is all whacked around. Your thinking is as bad as the alcoholic and addict. The sickness is there. You are powerless over drugs and alcohol, whether they're in you or someone else. So you can't trust what's going on. When you're new, it's all like, I don't get it. Go to meetings. If you contacted me and you decided you want to work with me, The first thing I'll say is, I'll ask you a series of questions, and one of them is, have you been going to meetings? Do you go to meetings? Have you ever been to a meeting? Right? Because you need that. One person is not going to be able to keep you balanced and on track. You have to figure out if you're on track. Okay? So that's my little analogy for the day. Have a wonderful weekend, and I'll talk to you soon.